Hi everyone, welcome to our third Fedora 6 demo. I'm David Wilcox, Program Leader for Fedora at Lyrisys, and I'm joined today by Bethany Seeger, Software Engineer at Johns Hopkins University. So in the first demo, we demonstrated the use of the migration tools to transform a Fedora 3 on-disk representation to OCFL, and the second demo showed how you can create RDF resources via the Fedora API and see those resources represented on disk as OCFL objects. So now in this third demo, we're going to show you how to create binary resources. Then we'll take a look under the hood at how those resources actually look on disk. And then we'll introduce the concept of archival groups, how to create them, and how to nest resources inside of them. So now for the demo, I'm going to turn it over to Bethany.
Thank you, and hello. So the first thing we're going to do is fire up Fedora here. And like last time, we're going to run it with the Jetty console in headless mode. And this time we're going to enable auto versioning for every change by including this flag here. So what that means is that when an object is changed, it's automatically going to be versioned, and we'll see that reflected in the OCFL object. So here we see Fedora starting up. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is create a binary resource, which is done similar to how it used to be done. You can see here's the name of it, plain old binary. It is a non-RDF source. The content type is going to be plain text, and we're simply putting in a file that says a test binary resource. So that was created successfully. And now we can check out what that looks like by retrieving that file. And so I've included the headers here, but here is the body of the resource, which is our string again. And like before with Fedora 4 and 5, you can tag on FCR metadata and retrieve the metadata, the RDF metadata about this object. Here's the body of it. And right now, this pretty much just has some server managed triples on it and no user managed triples. So let's take a peek at that on disk and what it looks like in OCFL. So here's the OCFL, what it looks like on disk. And you'll see we have our Fedora repository root object that's created when Fedora starts. And here we have our binary object with version 1 on it, and the content being binary. So here's the file itself. And then here is the metadata about the file. So that's pretty straightforward. Now let's talk about archival groups. Archival groups are used to direct Fedora to store a group of resources within a single OCFL object. As such, everything within that single OCFL object will be part of one versionable unit. So for example, suppose you had a single book with many associated pages that you wanted to live together on disk. Let's go ahead and create a book here. So here's our book 1, and it's a basic container. And what you'll see differently this time is that we're also sending in a link header for archival group. So we're indicating to Fedora that we want this particular container to also be an archival group. We're also sending in a little bit of RDF here. So we're sending in one triple to give our book a name. And we can take a quick peek at that. And see what that looks like. So here we have our RDF back from that. And you'll notice in the triples down here, so here's our RDF. You'll notice now there's a triple for indicating that this is an archival group. And if we include the headers in this call as well, we can see up here in the link header that it's included here as well. So there's two ways to indicate that it's an archival group. Let's take a quick peek at how that looks in OCFL. So we have our root object from before. Now here's our new object, book 1. It has a version 1 and a content of book 1 NT. So book 1NT is our user RDF that we specified. So I would expect to find the title in that file. So let's add a page to this book. So we're putting page one in book one here. Page one is a non-RDF source. It's an image JPEG. And then here's where I'm pulling the file from. So we don't have to specify anything here that it's an archival group, because that it's indicated by the fact that we're putting it in book one, and book one is an archival group. So let's see what that looks like on disk. So now our book one has version two. And what got added in version two is page one and page one description and T. I'm going to point out that we didn't add any user managed triples. So page one description and T is an empty file. And that'll be important in a minute. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to add page two. Pretty much the same command as before, except that a different name here. I'm grabbing a different file to put up there. So we've successfully created page two. We'll take a look at that on disk. So now we have book one with three versions, and then the third version, page two, got added. So notice that page one and page two, as expected, are nested in within the book one OCFL object. OCFL uses forward delta versioning, so the new versions only contain the files that have changed, and any that have not changed stay where they are, which is why you see book one here, and then adding page one and page one description NT here, and likewise with page two. So notice too that page two description NT file isn't visible here. That's part of the process that optimizes how files are stored. Since page two description NT is empty, its hash is equal to page one description NT, so the system doesn't have to save two separate files. What we'll do is take a look at version three inventory file. So under version three, just scroll up a little bit. Under version three, you can see that page one, well, let me highlight. So we're looking in the inventory.json file at version three. If I scroll down a little bit, you'll see that page one description NT and page two description NT have the same hash. It notes here that logically page two description NT is part of version three, but it also knows it doesn't need to save a copy of it because it can serve up the contents from page one description NT since the content there is the same. And with that, I'll hand it back to David.
Great, thanks Bethany. So this concludes the demo, but we'll continue to put these videos together as new features are added to Fedora 6. If you'd like to support our work, you can join us by becoming a member, and you can also sign up to participate in an upcoming code sprint. So the links, the relevant links will be in the video description. Thank you.